Dear friends, welcome to another video. This is Nick from educates.tv and today we're going to build a very interesting and useful project, an infrared thermometer with an LCD display using Arduino. Without any further delay, let's get started. A few weeks ago, icstation.com webstore contacted me and asked me if I wanted any items to build projects with them. After searching among the cool items they offer, I discovered two gems: the Nokia 5110 LCD display shield for Arduino and the MLX90614 IR temperature sensor. Since the Nokia 5110 is my favorite display to use with Arduino, this shield became my favorite at once, since it makes things so much easier. We don't need to connect wires anymore in order to use it, which makes prototyping a lot faster. It also has a small joystick embedded, and the price of it is less than $4, which is great. I combined these two items that icstation.com was kind enough to send me in order to build this infrared thermometer. You can find links for the parts in the description of the video.
The project is capable of measuring the temperature of an object without touching it from a small distance. It can measure temperatures from -70 degrees Celsius to 380 degrees. The accuracy is about half degree in room temperature, which is great.
Let's see the project in action. If I point the sensor at the cutting mat, the temperature it measures is around 21 degrees. Now, if I point the sensor at my palm, the temperature rises to 32 degrees Celsius. You may wonder why it does not measure 36.6 degrees Celsius. That's because the skin temperature of a human is different of the body temperature with 36.6. The normal skin temperature of a person is between 32 and 35 degrees Celsius. Let's measure the temperature of more objects. Cool, isn't it? Now let's see how to build this project. All we need is an Arduino Uno, the Nokia 5110 LCD shield and the MLX90614 IR sensor module. The sensor uses the I2C protocol, so it is extremely easy to make it work with Arduino. VCC goes to Arduino 5V, ground goes to Arduino ground, SCL goes to analog pin 5 of the Arduino Uno. Lastly, SDA goes to analog pin 4 of the Arduino. As you can see, the shield has all the pins of the Arduino Uno exposed, so it is very easy to work with it. Now we are ready to power up the project. As you can see, after displaying a splash screen for a few seconds, the project starts measuring the temperature. Now let's see the software side of the project.
The code of the project is very easy as well. We use the Adafruit MLX90614 library for the sensor and the Nokia 5110 graph library for the display. At first, we define if we want the temperature to be displayed in degrees Celsius or Fahrenheit. Next, the code, all it does is to read the object temperature from the sensor and display it on the screen. The sensor can also measure ambient temperature, but we are not using this feature today. If you don't have the LCD shield but you have a Nokia 5110 LCD display, you can use the code with a small change. Just change the pin number in this line of code here to match your connection. You can watch my previous tutorial on how to use the Nokia 5110 display in order to find out how to connect your display. As always, you can find the code of the project in the description of the video.
I am really impressed with the performance of this sensor and the applications that it may have. I have a couple of projects in mind that are going to use this sensor. Do you find this sensor useful, and if so, how do you plan to use it? Please post any ideas in the comment section below. I am once more impressed with the power of Arduino hardware and software. With less than $20 and within hours, one is able to build such useful devices. This project is a very clear demonstration of that. The time that anyone can build almost anything has come. Enjoy it! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build!